students, so this video is for class 6 social science. So today we're going to start with the first chapter from your social and political life, that is your diversity, right? So let's start. So what is diversity? A diversity in a simple term is a differences, okay? Differences regarding your thought, regarding your opinion, regarding your views, your practice, etc. Okay, so in our family also we have got a different thoughts, isn't it? Among your family members we have a different thoughts, isn't it? For example, your father might think in a different way, your mother might have a different opinion, you yourself have a different thoughts, isn't it? So there's no any kind of similarity. And in our society, if you check in our society, okay, there are different kinds of people living in our society with different religions, different rituals, different traditions, different culture, different language and all, isn't it? So that is a diversity, means differences, okay? So imagine if there were no diversity, isn't it? Everyone is speaking in same language, everyone living same kind of lifestyle, isn't it? Same tradition, same culture, then I believe we have a very monotonous life, isn't it? Very, very boring life, isn't it? But thankfully, we are not living in such kind of society, okay? We have got a diverse society, okay? So now there is a confusion regarding the word diversity and inequality, inequality, okay? Got it? So what I told you about the diversity, I hope you are clear, isn't it? So inequality means a kind of what differences, okay, a kind of unequal regarding your source resources and your opportunities, okay? Got it? So means here kind of discrimination among the people, okay? For example, in our India there is a caste system, isn't it? Caste system means we have got a different caste, isn't it? High class, middle caste, low caste, isn't it? High caste people are given much priorities as compared to the low caste, isn't it? So, and there is a difference of rich and poor also, isn't it? Rich peoples, they are being given more priorities, they are given respect, isn't it? And whereas the whereas the poor people, they are always been discriminated by the high class people, okay? Got it? So that is the inequality. Okay, so there is no any similarity among the word diversity and inequality. Okay, I hope you are clear, right? Next is your causes of diversity. So there are various reasons behind the causes of diversity, like your history, geography, occupational differences, language, religions, and physical features or physical characteristics of a people. Okay, so first is history. So history, if you go to the past days, then most of the travelers, they used to travel through the countries, okay, through the places to in order to explore a new land, isn't it? So when they used to find out the new land, they used to settle down out there, isn't it? They used to interact with the people living on those areas, okay? Got it? And what happens, their language and their customs and the people and the languages where the people they are existing, okay, they used to combine each other and they used to form a new language, okay? The new language or a new custom used to evolve out, okay? So in same way, in our India, Muslims has came, okay, to in India in the past days. They settled down in our country, and with them they brought a Persian language, and that Persian language and the Indian language, they combined to form a new language, that was Urdu, right? So in same way, geography, okay, next is your geography. So geography, our India has a different landforms, isn't it? From northern part to the southern part, you're going to find a different landforms in our country, isn't it? So you're going to find mountains, desert, plains, plateaus, etc., isn't it? So the people living in different landforms, they have got a different lifestyle, isn't it? The people who are living in mountainous regions, they love to wear warm clothes, isn't it? And the people who are living in plain areas, they prefer to wear light cotton clothes, right? So next is your occupational differences. So people living in different landforms, they have got their own occupations also, like for example, the people who are living in coastal regions, their main occupation is fishing. The people who are living in plain areas, their main occupation is agriculture, right? So now next is your languages. So languages, in our India, we're going to find a different languages, isn't it? The people who are living in Punjab, they speak in Punjabi. People living in Bengal, they speak in Bengali, isn't it? So there are altogether more than 1600 languages in our country. And among them, 22 are been recognized by the Constitution of India. And your English is considered as, is been recognized as the official language. Okay, so next is your religion. So our India also have a different religion, isn't it? There is Hinduism, Buddhism, Christianity, Muslim, etc. Got it? So, but still there is a kind of oneness, kind of togetherness among ourselves. Okay, got it? So that's why our considered, our country is considered as a secular country, isn't it? Next is your physical characteristics of a people. So there is a difference in the physical characteristics of a people also, okay, like your facial appearance, your height, everything, okay, that none of they are similar to each other. Is it some of people they have got a short height, some of they have got a tall, is it some of they have got a fair skin, some of they have got dark skin, some of they have got chinky eyes, some of they have got broad eyes, is it? So there is a differences among ourselves. Okay, got it? So next is about your diversity in India. So India is a country where you're going to find our diverse, isn't it, diverse people living in our country. So if you talk about the relief features also, I told you already, we have got a different relief features, isn't it? We have got a different languages, different customs, different traditions, different religions and all, isn't it? But still there is kind of togetherness, oneness among ourselves, isn't it? There is a unity in diversity in our country, isn't it? So and we have always proved that whenever any kind of situation occurs in our country, we are always together to face it, right? So in if you talk about the time of independence also, that our people has came together, they all came together to fight against British rule, and finally they succeed also, isn't it? And now we are living in a free country, isn't it? So now next is about your how diversity enrich our lives. So I told you already that if you have got the same lifestyle, isn't it? Same thoughts, same group of people, same languages, same traditions and all, then our life will be monotonous, right? So it's always good to learn new things, isn't it? It will be always helpful for us, isn't it? It's always, we always have to appreciate to learn a new languages, to understand the new new traditions, new rituals and all, isn't it? So it will enrich our knowledge also, plus our going to groom our ideas and all, isn't it? And plus it will going to help us to treat everyone in a positive way. Okay, so that comes to the end of your chapter, and I've given the home assignment. Hope you're going to do it.